What is up, guys? It's Tommy here and welcome to the latest Liverpool transfer news video. And the first and the biggest news is that Virgil van Dijk reportedly told Southampton he doesn't want to play for them anymore, and he basically went on strike because he wants to move to Liverpool. Let me know, what do you think about this news in the comments below, and do you think the Naby Keita deal is dead or not? I will make an update video on that tomorrow. But first of all, let me apologize for not uploading for 3 days. I was traveling from Groningen from the Netherlands to Hungary, and the drive took me 2 days via Stuttgart, and I just had no internet at the hotel that I stayed. The internet wasn't working, so I couldn't upload, so I apologize. We arrived back to Hungary very late yesterday evening, so now I'm well rested, and the daily uploads will continue from today, and the career mode video is coming probably tomorrow morning as well, so stay tuned for that. Van Dijk told the new Southampton manager Mauricio Pellegrino that he's not available to play, he's not in the frame of mind to play, so Southampton made him train alone in Southampton while the whole team is in a training camp in France, which is very, very interesting. And basically this is an attempt from Van Dijk to force through a transfer move to Liverpool because he's absolutely desperate to play for Jurgen Klopp and Liverpool. But Liverpool are in a very, you know, delicate position because they they officially ended their interest in Van Dijk in a public statement because, Southampton were reporting them to the Premier League for a breach of, the transfer conduct. And, Liverpool can't really make the first full move unless Southampton say that they want to sell. But Southampton won't publicly say that because they publicly said many times that they don't want to sell any of their top players this summer. But it's a very dangerous position to be in for Southampton because most young players like to go there because they have a pathway to a bigger club than Southampton at the end of their Southampton career. And Van Dijk, he signed a new 6-year contract last summer, and now he wants to leave, which of course is understandable, but Southampton are perfectly within their rights to say that he's not for sale. But the thing is, in my opinion, if Liverpool offers 65 to 70 million pounds for Van Dijk, then I think they will sell. But the thing is, with these big transfer deals, it sometimes takes weeks, sometimes even months to get them done, and Liverpool might have to wait until the last week of the transfer window to get the Van Dijk transfer done, to get the Naby Keita deal done. But I want to read you the quotes of the Southampton manager Pellegrino, who of course is a former Liverpool player and a former Liverpool assistant manager, very interestingly. So Pellegrino said, Van Dijk said that he's not available to play because he wants to leave. I had to say, if you don't want to be involved because you don't feel okay, then you have to train alone until this period of time is over. So Van Dijk publicly said to the manager that he wants to leave, which is of course very good, but this still doesn't mean that he will sign for Liverpool. That's the problem. And Pellegrino also said, and I quote, "I was clear with the boy and I was talking from the first day with him. The club was clear. The club told me they will not sell Van Dijk. I will communicate the idea of the club to the players. And for me, it was easy to leave Van Dijk out of training because I had to manage the dynamic of the team. Now he's not involved with the team because he psychologically is not 100%. If you are not 100% with the team, I need to work with the players who are 100% to defend Southampton. It's easy for me." And also Pellegrino said, "I repeat that the club said no to a sale. I hope that Van Dijk can review his feelings because you know that today the player is big business. Not just the player, but behind them is a lot of interest. I don't want to say too much, but we need the player 100%. I want to have the squad, I want to have Van Dijk, but we need a player, and I repeat, involved in every training session, not just with the body, but with the mind on the pitch with the rest of the players." So Van Dijk's mind is clearly at Liverpool. He wants to sign for Liverpool. But at the moment, Southampton are really digging their heels in, really, trying to do everything they can to force Van Dijk to stay. which is of course a very, very interesting position. I think this is why, you know, it's a big, big shift in the Premier League in terms of, you know, this TV deal, which benefits all the Premier League clubs now. Basically, you have to pay absolutely crazy money to get these top players. And I think Liverpool have to really, really pay over the odds for Van Dijk, but he's worth it. He would absolutely transform our defense, and the main problem have been Liverpool's defense in the last few years. It hasn't been scoring goals under Jurgen Klopp. We always scored a lot of goals, and we will continue to score a lot of goals. But if we can concede easy, cheap goals like we have done so many times, the last season, the season before last season, until that is fixed, Liverpool can't really seriously think about winning the Premier League title. And we need at least Van Dijk and a centre midfielder, either Keita or somebody else, to really seriously be thinking about challenging for the Premier League title. And I think that's what Jurgen Klopp wants, that's what Liverpool are building for. But all the top clubs are signing huge, huge players with huge money. Morata signed for Chelsea for crazy money, Lukaku signed for Man United, and look at Manchester City. They spent £130 million on their defense alone, on just their fullbacks, which is crazy. They signed Kyle Walker and Danilo and Mendy from Monaco as well, and those three players who are free fullbacks cost 130 million. So this shows that in today's transfer market you absolutely have to pay crazy money to get the top players, and Man City are doing so, Man United are doing so, Arsenal signed Lacazette, and Liverpool, just to keep up with the top four, Liverpool have to spend this money. So I think, even though Liverpool publicly ended their interest in Southampton player Van Dijk, we should go in with a big bid, like 65 million. If Southampton say no, let's bid 70 million. If they say no to that as well, and Van Dijk just basically doesn't want to play for Southampton, he could here hand in a transfer request. If Southampton still doesn't want to sell, then we should move on to another target, because there is no point waiting until the last week of the transfer window. The reason why Southampton don't really want to sell any of their star players is because they have a new set of board directors who want to change the club's transfer policy a little bit, and they are basically remaining adamant that this will be the first summer since 2014 where Southampton don't sell any of their star players, including Van Dijk, including Ryan Bertrand, who has been linked to Manchester City. But I don't think that Man City want to sign him, because Man City already spent a fortune on free fullbacks, as I already earlier said in this video. And Pellegrino is prepared to tell Van Dijk once again that no matter what, Southampton won't sell him. Is that really a case, or are Southampton just playing hardball and trying to get as much money for Van Dijk as possible? We don't really know that. We don't really know the behind the scenes of what is going on. But definitely Van Dijk wants to join Liverpool. He went on strike. He told Southampton, the manager, the board, that he wants to leave. I'm not sure what else can Van Dijk do, and I'm not sure what else can Liverpool do, but Liverpool should really bid 65 million or 70 million for Van Dijk and see how much Southampton want to keep Van Dijk, because to turn down that amount of money, even for Southampton, they have to consider that offer. And you know, Southampton are really not in Europe, not in the Champions League, so they are building just for the Premier League season, and I'm not sure if this is the right idea to do for Southampton. But of course, from a Liverpool point of view, I just want Van Dijk to join Liverpool and to make us stronger. But let me know, what do you want to see in the Van Dijk transfer saga, and who else should Liverpool target? In my opinion, I think we should wait until maybe the last 2 weeks of the transfer window, and if there is nothing going on with the Van Dijk transfer, then we should move on to another target similar to the Keita transfer. We should start working with different targets, different center backs, different center midfielders, because I'm sure that there are alternatives to Van Dijk, there are alternatives to Naby Keita, maybe players who are not as good as them but almost as good, and and Liverpool really need to strengthen. We need to, you know, sign players who are better than what we already have. Otherwise, there is no point building the squad up with mediocre players. But that's just my opinion. I want to hear your opinion, guys, in the comments below. Let me know, and thanks for watching, guys. Stay tuned for more videos. See you later. Goodbye.